India ranks number one in tuberculosis, number one in cervical cancer deaths, and among the highest malnutrition in the world. And yet it's among the leaders in software innovation, mathematics, physics, astronomy. It's just that there's been a huge barrier, bureaucratic as well as financial, that have prevented the healthcare space and the medical discovery space to really bloom.
Today we are heading towards patient's house in Sahakar Nagar. Patients are really very happy that we can do something, we can bring some facilities to their doorsteps.
The Indo-US Clinical Research and Education Partnership started with a single NIH grant to study maternal infant HIV transmission.
In Pune in 1992, HIV was very, very new. There was a lot of stigma. There wasn't a lot of attention paid to it, and we established the first clinics to screen pregnant women for HIV, giving them access after the diagnosis to treatment, which they wouldn't have had if they hadn't been tested.
India has both the human talent, has the patient populations who have great need, and Hopkins has some of the expertise in study design that we come together and help each other to address some of the global health challenges we have.
The mission of Indo-US partnership is to conduct high quality, high priority collaborative research and education that tackles the leading causes of death in India from infectious diseases such as tuberculosis, HIV, AIDS, and antimicrobial resistance. Our first study, which was a 6-week esclavinebripine study conducted between 2002 and 2007, was the first ever phase 3 clinical trial in India that addressed the prevention of mother-to-child transmission of HIV.
When that trial showed we could reduce the risk of transmission by almost 50%, that got adopted by the World Health Organization guideline. And that means that we went from just showing it in a few hundred women to several hundreds of thousands of women around the world.
There are several studies that are running at the clinical research site at any given point, and every study has a unique research question. So one of the challenges is to collect the data from all the different studies and apply the appropriate statistical methodology to answer the research question the study is trying to answer. One of the biggest improvements is that we are able to capture data directly onto the system and have completely stopped using paper case report forms. That's a big advantage in terms of data collection.
So this database specifically is a collection of about 13,000 records.
When you have a huge data set like this from a big program, there are lots of things you could do with the data.
We were involved in helping provide training opportunities for many people in India who are now some of the leading scientists in the country. Many of them are alumni of the Hopkins program.
Fogarty program has helped us in capacity building of the faculty. These Fogarty fellows, they are working on 10 different research topics. Many of them are very innovative. I would definitely say that it has helped our patients and at large the society.
We learn as much from our colleagues in India, certainly if not more than what we're able to provide them.
Overall, the faculties of BJGMC Pune have been exposed to world-class research. Also, they are getting the benefit of world-class labs which we have set up here under this partnership.
As a head of a clinical unit, I am looking after the clinical care of the patients and research work done by the postgraduate students.
The medical students as well as the postgraduate students and the faculties are getting exposed to the research culture.
We have become more methodical and more of an international standard research is going on at this moment.
The institute has benefited a lot by being now seen as a hub for clinical research, not only in India, but also abroad. And a lot of other universities are now collaborating with us or wanting to collaborate. But the Hopkins remains the best and close to our heart.
Whether it be transmission of HIV or looking at what we could do to treat TB better, we struggle both across the 10,000 mile gap, the same issues.
Solutions that we come up with together with our colleagues in India for improving health outcomes have great potential benefit beyond India, even in our own society.
We want to see an improvement in healthcare and outcomes for people living in India as well as those living around the world. We will be one of the key players at the table to eliminate TB, to work on elimination of HIV and other infectious diseases that impact India and beyond.
There's both a need and a tremendous opportunity to continue collaborations, international collaborations between scientists in India scientists in the United States. I think we have a model for how to do that. India benefits, the whole world benefits.